The president is the chief executive officer of this corporation called the United States of America.
Can you handle the truth? Welcome to the Jordan Maxwell Show.
Hello, my friends. This is Jordan Maxwell. I'm back with you live this time. I've been having a lot of problems with my life and being able to do the shows and do what I want to do. So I've been struggling to fight enemies and all kinds of problems. So that's why I so many times have been able to miss doing my show on Saturday evenings. And so I want to apologize for that, but I'm still struggling to stay alive. I have many enemies that do not want me doing what I do and are seeking to make sure that I fail in my mission to wake people up. So there's a lot of strange things going on around the world, and people like myself and others who are on the cutting edge of trying to wake people up are having enormous amount of problems. I've talked about this before, but I think it bears witness again to talk about it for a moment. If you want to get a little knowledge about something in this world, you get what you pay for. If you want a little knowledge, well, then you can probably get a book on the subject you're interested in. Cost a few dollars, and that's about it. But if you want a deeper understanding, maybe you can go to a school or a seminar or something like that, and it may cost you a little more money, but this way you'll be able to hear experts, and ask questions. But that's going to cost you more than a book. And of course, if you really want more information, well, of course, you can go to university, go to college, or study the subject. But that's really going to cost you now when you're going to college and university. There's no guarantee you get what you're looking for anyway. But the point being is that you get in this world what you pay for. So if you want knowledge, you're going to pay a little something. If you want a little more knowledge, then you're going to pay a little more. If you want the really important knowledge, the kind that people are looking for but don't have, you're really going to pay for that. And once you finally get into this whole idea of the truth as opposed to the mainstream lies and deception, you're going to discover, as I have and others like me, that the world becomes very different than what you think it is. Once you really begin to delve into the dark side of humanity, the dark side of the world you live in, government, law, commerce, etc., you will begin to find out, as others have, as I have, that there's a world of darkness out there that does not want you probing what they're doing. And they will do whatever they can to harass you, to destroy your name, your reputation, to rip you off, steal from you, do whatever they can to ruin you and your reputation and your work. So what I'm saying is that when you do the kind of research that I've been doing on secret societies and what's going on behind the world powers, that's very dangerous, I have come to understand. I thought I was doing something, something of importance many years ago when I first started getting into the world of secret societies and hidden symbols and generally speaking, the occult world. And the word occult, I have to say again, the word occult simply means hidden, period. And so anything which is hidden is occult. And so I got into the world back in 1959, 1960s. I mean, almost, 57 years ago, something like that. I became very interested in the secret world of power around me. Who really owns the banks? Who really runs government? Who is it that has the authority to print money? Who do the police represent? What is government? Where, what is religion? And where did theology and religion come from? And what, the more you begin to look at the world you live in, the more it becomes obvious that there is a dark force that is in place around the world. All over this earth, there is a dark, sinister, and evil presence behind the scenes that is making sure that everything runs the way it's supposed to, and that the rich get richer and the poor get poorer, and the millions of people in the street who are frustrated and angry at the system, all they can do is go out into the streets in a massive demonstration of their hatred for the system. And their frustration and vent their frustration on riots, etc. Now, I realized that there's something wrong a long time ago when I was a kid. And I knew that there was, powers behind the people who supposedly are running our country. And so, the longer I played with this subject and read and studied and asked questions and would research on these questions. Like I said, for some 56 years, I've been doing nothing but that. And it's become an extraordinary experience in my life. At 76 years old, I have been doing this for, like I said, about 56 years of my life. And I have come across some extraordinary information, which is going to happen if you keep continually reading and studying and talking to people who are in the know, corresponding with research societies, and just living the life of a maverick researcher, author, writer. You're going to find some really interesting stuff that's going on in the world, but most people are not aware of. And when you do, you're also going to find that you've opened up a can of worms, and you're going to have to pay for the knowledge you've obtained. You're going to pay for. Some people pay with their lives. Some researchers pay with their broken families. quite a few of them end up in prison and lost their freedom and lost their family. And that's the way it's always been. I mean, even go back to things as mundane as Nikola Tesla during the 100 years that he was around. Nikola Tesla was a great electrician, genius in electricity, and gave us the world that we live in today, and yet he died a pauper and was continually fighting the powers that be that did not want him to explain to us how we could get free energy forever just out of the earth. So I know what happened to people like that who are on the cutting edge and trying to help their fellow man. They usually end up in prison, dead, broke, or something. And so I pretty much knew that when I first started. I kind of figured that's what was ultimately going to happen to me. And it has. But I would not take anything for the privilege I've had of being able to know what I know and what I've been through and what I have seen with my own eyes and witnessed as to how this world really works. It's an extraordinary story of betrayal of the human race. So as a matter of fact, I mentioned quite a few years ago, I started talking about the fact that there was one subject in particular that I was really very interested in. And out of that, of course, came many other kindred subjects that I got involved with. But this one subject I happened to stumble upon it back in 1967. My God, that's a long time ago. 1967, I was in Glendale, California, and some of you may have heard the story before, but I was in Glendale, California, at a Glendale library, looking at some information and doing some research on the Nazi Party and the Communist Party and the fascist movement, fascist world movement. And I was preparing to do a seminar on the subject of secret societies in world religion and government. And this was in 1967, late 67. And I came across an article in the World Book Encyclopedia, on the subject of Russia and Soviet Union. And on the first page of that article, there was, of course, pictures of the Red Square, and on the lower right of the first page was two pictures, one showing the national flag of the Soviet Communist Empire. And it was, of course, the red flag with the hammer and sickle. And then beneath that, there was another picture of the National Coat of Arms, the official seal, so to speak, of the Soviet Union. And that official seal caught my eye. And for some reason, which I have no idea why, I realized with an immediacy that I was seeing something which ultimately is going to be extraordinarily important in the world to come, in the world of symbols. This was in 67, and that symbol was the National Coat of Arms for the Soviet Union, which had a reef of wheat wrapped around, like the United Nations symbol, a reef wrapped around the earth. And there was a sunrise behind the earth with the hammer and sickle. But the mere fact of that sunrise behind the earth caught my attention. And I realized that there was something about that symbol that I've seen before. And this is what I have been doing pretty much all my life, is what you would call pattern recognition. And I had already watched and seen this same symbol of the sun rising over the earth, sun rising over the mountains of the east, et cetera, et cetera. And I began just reading that little article. It was only about two or three sentences, but what it said struck my attention like a brick hitting me in the head. And I realized that this is very important, and I didn't know how important. Well, that was back in 67. And since 1967, I've been researching this same subject, because I know that there's something, and each year I become more and more convinced that this is a monumental, monstrous subject, this symbol. And so I've wanted to do, over the years, I've wanted to do a video on this subject and bring this particular symbol of the Soviet National Coat of Arms and what it actually represents, bring this information out into the world for the people of this world to see where it came from and what it means and what it implies. And I've done a little bit of that from time to time over the years, but with the coming of computers into my life in the mid-90s, I began to be able to, for the first time, to do what I wanted to do technologically with computers. Because before, I was just photographing documents and pictures, etc., and doing slide presentations, slideshows. And that worked for a while, but it really wasn't very impressive to the audience or me, but at least it got my message out. But with the coming of the computer and the technology, I've been able to now do a lot more and a lot better presentations. And so all of this I'm saying is to let you know that I now have a documentary that I have produced is called Cosmocratorus or Cosmocrat.